How's it going, everybody? We are back for another reaction today. Today we are going to be doing the top 10 military drones of 2021. There is one that I see in the thumbnail that I believe was actually before 2021, but we'll go ahead and see if it's in there. I can't really give my professional opinion on these drones because I'm sure they're not going to explain all the tech in the drones and exactly what they do, but I think we'll just go ahead and just kind of watch through most of the video, and then I'll just kind of get my final thoughts at the end. But let's go ahead and just jump right into it.
The technology behind unmanned air systems, or UAS, has taken off in recent years, and as a result, UAS can fly faster and further than ever before, performing ever more sophisticated surveillance operations. Stick with us till the end of the video to know more about these interesting and high-tech gadgets. Let's get started. Number 10. Vapor. The all-electric Vapor helicopter unmanned aircraft system is extremely versatile and can be custom configured to support a variety of mission requirements. Featuring military-grade components, Vapor is powered by proprietary HeliSynth technology, delivering precision flight performance, exceptional endurance, and maximum payload flexibility for defense, commercial, and industrial applications. Number 9. Novadem NX-70. NX-70 is a micro quadcopter based on a four-legged airframe. The forward and rear body of the UAV is fitted with extended arms. The forward and rear body of the UAV is fitted with extended arms integrating rotor hubs. Each rotor hub is installed with a two-bladed propeller driven by an electric motor. The UAV measures 51 cm long, 51 cm wide, and 13 cm high. The maximum takeoff weight of the aircraft is 1 kg. NX-70 can be easily integrated into larger platforms, such as weapon systems, to deliver improved operational flexibility. Number 8. Anafi USA. Weighing 1.1 pound, the Anafi USA unmanned aerial vehicle employs quad rotor design that folds easily. The UAV dimensions when folded and unfolded are 9.92 inches by 4.9 inches by 3.23 inches. And 11.10 inches by 14.69 inches by 3.30 inches respectively. It can be launched and recovered by the user from the palm of the hand to enable rapid deployment. The UAV is integrated with advanced flight features such as the Free Flight 6 flying interface, which offers a more intuitive and smoother piloting experience. The application allows the users to alter piloting modes from manual to automatic and offers multiple.
So let's talk about just some of the drones we saw so far. Pretty cool drones. Obviously, like I said, I really can't give too much of an opinion on them, only because I've never flown them. They give you very limited information on exactly what these drones do. Now there is unfortunately, a lot of us in the US, we fly DJI, which is a Chinese company. I'm not really fond on supporting Chinese companies, but unfortunately a lot of the American companies are more geared towards doing military projects, not so much for the general public. You got Anafi, you got Altel, you got Skydio. They all seem to do more for the military than they do, you know, for the private sector as far as the everyday person. Now they all do make drones for, you know, the general public, but their main bread and butter is definitely military applications. But let's go ahead and just jump right back into it.
Imaging options. Number 7. Alpha 800. The Alpha 800 is simply the best in its class. It is the most reliable and durable unmanned helicopter available for a multitude of monitoring tasks. Utilizing a UAV platform that flies in fully autonomous and or manual mode, or both, the Alpha 800 does much of the same work as a manned helicopter, but with far lower maintenance requirements and overall costs. Very light and easy maneuverable at less than 14 kilograms. It is not affected by regulations that severely limit the use of heavier UAVs. Its lightweight enhances versatility in a wide range of missions. Number 6. Thor. Thor is a vertical takeoff and landing, or VTOL, mini unmanned aircraft system developed by Elbit Systems, a global defense electronics company based in Israel. The multi-rotor drone will be deployed in surveillance and reconnaissance missions over land and at sea. The VTOL unmanned aircraft is suitable for performing operations in urban environments with non-line of sight communication or over complex terrain due to its automatic takeoff and landing. It also has the capability of performing autonomous missions. Number 5. Spike Firefly. Spike Firefly miniature tactical loitering weapon is a new member of Spike family of precision-guided missiles developed by Rafael Advanced Defense System, a defense technology company based in Israel. The loitering munition is intended for use by dismounted infantry, marines, and special forces personnel in urban warfare. Typical mission capabilities of the Firefly include situational awareness, engagement of enemy targets beyond line of sight, scouting for maneuvering force, and tactical reconnaissance in urban battlefield scenarios. Number 4. Songar. The armed drone system is the first indigenous drone with machine gun stabilization in Turkish Armed Forces inventory. Patented stabilization system enables a drone-mounted machine gun to effectively shoot up to 200 bullets per flight. Easily transportable and deployable, Songar TM armed drone system is a force multiplier in small wars. The bullet magazine can be changed, thus enabling the operator to quickly reload for mission continuity. Executes the mission in full autonomy and multi-layered safety until final operator consent for firing. Ergonomic and friendly system designed to reduce operator load during mission, drone return home on link loss, in-flight mission change, autonomous and remote control modes, etc. Number 3. Pegasus. Pegasus family of transformable unmanned aerial systems / unmanned tactically deployable autonomous robotic system can operate as a VTOL UAS and a tracked UGV. The Pegasus range is equipped with artificial intelligence, which allows the vehicles to avoid obstacles and create full 3D mapping in any environment. Number 2. Skydio X2. Skydio, the Redwood City, California startup, is flying high. Skydio's X2 drones were announced today, along with $100 million in Series C funding, which follows a $4 million investment that the U.S. Department of Defense announced this weekend. $100 million may be the largest funding round the drone industry has seen so far, certainly one of the largest that has hit headlines since Precision Hawk scored $75 million in 2018. Drone investments broke records in 2019, but the investment environment has shifted. While the hype cycle is over, investors are certainly still willing to put money into new technology with new capabilities and the market need. Number 1. Black Hornet. The Black Hornet Nano is a military micro unmanned aerial vehicle developed by Prox Dynamics AS of Norway and in use by the armed forces of the United States, France, the United Kingdom, Germany, Australia, Turkey, Norway, the Netherlands, and India. The unit measures around 10 by 2.5 centimeters and provides troops on the ground with local situational awareness. They are small enough to fit in one hand and weigh just over half an ounce.
Okay, so I do have a couple thoughts on some of the drones, like the Songar. That was the one with the machine gun that was mounted on the bottom. In wartime, I don't really think that that would be all that great of a platform, only because if you got 30 guys on the ground and they're all shooting at you, it really only takes one of them to sit there and aim at that drone and hit it a couple of good times with a couple rounds, and that thing's going down. I mean, it's just, unless that it has automatic aiming and that shit is on point, I just don't see that being too viable. And the last one was the one I was talking about at the beginning of the video, the Black Hornet. That little helicopter cost, if I'm not mistaken, was around $80,000 a piece. I just don't see what it does that warrants that kind of price tag. I mean, it's a cool little device. It's super small. I don't understand what's in it that would warrant that, because it seems, I don't see it being worth $80,000, but that's just my personal opinion. But just let me know down in the comments what you guys thought of any of the drones in here and what your thoughts are on what I said. And if you liked the video, just give it a thumbs up and subscribe, and we'll see you guys next time.